Mr. Chairman, members of the committee, Scott Bach, Association of New Jersey Rifle and Pistol Clubs, and a former member of law enforcement. Let's not kid ourselves about this bill. It's based on the fantasy that we will somehow be safer if we just wave a magic wand and remove a certain tool from society. If that were true, then banning matches would stop arson, banning knives would prevent stabbings. If box cutters can bring down the World Trade Center, does anybody really believe that banning box cutters will stop the next terror attack? Those bent on doing evil are going to do evil. No matter what tool is available, a car driven into a crowd can be more lethal than a gun, as we discovered this morning. So can a pressure cooker, and so can a gang of terrorists with knives, as shown in last week's massacre in China. The cold hard truth is that no one will be any safer under this feel-good legislation, because criminals and madmen will ignore it or find another tool. And even if they followed it, magazines can be changed in an instant. The claim that you can just tackle a homicidal maniac during a magazine change is absurd and not supported by the weight of the evidence. And if you really cared about giving folks a fighting chance against a mass murderer, you wouldn't make them tackle the madman. You'd let them defend themselves with a firearm instead of denying their right to carry.
How about that? Yeah.
People ask me why anyone needs a magazine over 10 rounds. The answer is for the same reasons that police do. They might face multiple assailants. Criminals travel in packs, and home invasions happen. When a gang of armed thugs kicks in your door at 3 a.m., they won't be using 10-round magazines, and the government shouldn't make you fumble around in the dark changing yours to save your family's life. The Supreme Court has repeatedly ruled that police owe no duty to protect individual citizens, which means you're on your own in an emergency. Law-abiding citizens should be free to have as much firepower as possible to fend off an attack without interference by the same government that says it has no duty to protect you. This bill is also a flat-out gun ban, a direct attack on sportsmen and hunters that would outlaw dozens of popular rifles. Their owners would be turned into felons and forced to abandon their property or go to prison for as long as 10 years. The bill contains no grandfathering, no amnesty, nothing to distinguish New Jersey's 1 million legal gun owners from felons and homicidal madmen. The distinction between good guys and bad guys is easy to make, unless going after the good guys is the true intent. Has it never occurred to anyone to limit the bill to just felons and those involved in serious crimes, instead of trampling everyone's self-defense rights? The absence of that distinction can mean only one thing. This bill has little to do with public safety and a lot to do with politics and the steady crush of Second Amendment rights. It will not stand. Thank you.
We have one question.
Bill, really, in your testimony, you mentioned something regarding Supreme Court ruling. Could you go into a little bit more?
Sure. Surprising as it may be to many people, policemen are surprised by this. The U.S. Supreme Court has repeatedly held over and over and over again that police have no duty to protect individual citizens. Their duty is owed to society as a whole. What that means is if you're in an emergency and you need to dial 911, it means that if the police don't show up for 4 hours or if they never show up at all, you have no recourse. What that means is you're on your own in an emergency. And what this bill does is it basically says, okay, you're on your own in an emergency, but by the way, we're going to tie one hand behind your back so you can't defend yourself, okay, when the police are not able to be there, okay? Bottom line, when seconds count in an emergency, police are minutes away. I'm a former member of law enforcement myself, so I understand this. Police can't be everywhere. They're not omnipresent. If you're on your own in an emergency, the state should not prevent you from doing everything you need to do to defend yourself and your family.